some time at a senior level. And at this tournament, for the qualifiers for the World Cup, they played a game against Lesotho. But Lesotho brought their game here in the qualifiers. Will once again try to more pressure on the strikers of. Guns watching at the moment. So we look at the Congo operation of so the player just came on, he's a midfielder, plays for a team called Saint Michel. Here comes El Ghadi Opoku. The battle of the midfielders, as that's where it all happens. Ah, beautiful. Former Ghanaian player, beg your pardon. Some other star players can talk about for Ghana. Besides the like. Okufo. Collected there by the Kepi State Stadium. It is Ghana, they are leading. Sabu. Closed down by Opoku. Who does well. So Olivia about to make a change as well. Yeah, that's trying to get across into the penalty area. Beg your pardon. There was nobody there for him to play the ball to. Indian players have everybody behind the ball now at the moment. So now that Ethiopia has arrived here at the stadium. Well, played over the center. Jaden collected quickly. Here comes the captain of the side of Ghana, talking about years of age from Accra in Ghana. 15th cap for his country, Ethiopia, at the start of this tie. And all of those shots have gone straight to the goalkeeper of Ghana. So a minute remaining. We are still in the first half. Ethiopia holding their own in the last game against Ghana will be the ones that go through. So it is really massive for both these sides. Ghana cannot allow Ethiopia to settle and square goal because they will be forced to come in. Opoku immediately going on attack here. He comes in for the injured Mpong. Shetan Pong will not continue with this tie as he just made India first appearance in Nations Cup in 31 years. Last year, Ethiopia. And on the other hand, as well, did not have the best of tournament. Adusei scored his first goal for the national team, the senior national team, when they played in a previous tie against it was the game, the assistant coach to the now coach Kwesi Appiah. And has taken Ghana to yet another World Cup. Now, boy, in a tie against Ethiopia, it was a crucial one. Scored his first goal for the national team. A penalty he took after Bansi had gone down in the penalty area. West B, that is Ghana, got a bye and were awarded a 3-0 victory as Benin withdrew from the qualifiers. And was joined by Nigeria and Burkina Faso. 2-1, they won at home, but they lost 1-0 when they went away to Congo. Then it was the battle of the losers. Cameroon, who had lost against Gabon after a 1-1 draw, 7-6. Try and find a goal here. Goalless draw it is at the moment. And we're looking for the opening goal. Nice 1-2 for Ghana. Can they unload the defense? Yahaya goes in, gets the ball now towards Opoku, and appeals for a penalty, and they get one. As the ball played in, now that hand was fully stressed out.
Boko into the area, Nagbe punches away. Scrambling, Nigeria came away with it for a moment. Here's a Poku. lovely little skill over the top. Zimbabwe and Libya. Hour gone here between Ghana and Nigeria. Still no goals. 3 hours of football plus added time. No goals. Afu. Opoku. Looking for the heights of Abushnaf. Deceptively tall player. Gets his nose into dangerous areas. Jordan Opoku. Through for Ghana. Feed in. This time goes long. Noosh noosh. Almagasi. On the overlap. Taking it past to Gianni. Cuts back inside of Onoba. Jordan Opoku showing why he wears that captain's armband. Such leadership. No half-time substitutions either for either one of these sides. For Libya, get them into a position from which to take a shot. Opoku, better from Ghana. They've got four men pushing forward. Delivery out in the far. Kept in play by Omar, who for a moment was standing in an offside position, so El Tribi couldn't release him. Libya looked threatening, and now the counter-attack is on itself. Nigeria, Ghana, and the North African representatives, Algeria.
And it looks like, you know, the local blasters are spirited by, or have been invigorated. Continue.
Jordan Opoku for Ghana. A lovely ball down the left side here. Sule Mohammed. Lovely ball. The area of Senegal. This is Jordan Opoku for Ghana. And now.
Jordan Opoku in possession. Jordan. And Kotoko are pinging the ball around very well, Kwabena. They are pinging the ball, trying to pick out Yahya Mohammed. And you also must add that Kotoko are without Helegbe. He picked up an injury in the opening minutes, in the opener against Ediana Stars. So Yahya Mohammed, who started from the bench, is now getting in.
Well, unfortunately, Hearts also missed crosses from Yahya Mohammed. And Hearts get the ball away. And it was a very, very tricky ball. It was heading all the way into the corner of the post. And Tete Lugard was absolutely brilliant. Bobby Anta was the man. Jordan, Lusua Kufu, finds a Kufu, and is Robert Fiamanyo with a strike here, and is Jordan Opoku, such an intelligent and witty player. Hit the ball upfield, yeah, Mohammed controls it, and looks for, well, Jordan Opoku, it's two against two, yeah, Mohammed has an opportunity, yeah, Mohammed, effort, gotta go have a corner kick, we see the counter attack. Very well lifted here, Mohammed tried to go for